Hello, and welcome to another video in the Godot series. Today, I wanted to have a look at unit testing in Godot. Testing your code makes it easier to refactor your code down the line and make sure that you're not making any changes that break your game. You can imagine if you have a really big game, playing through it every single time you make a change is not maintainable and scalable. So with testing, you can make sure that the core parts and all the other parts of your code still works. So let's get into it for Godot. Now there's an amazing library for unit testing in Godot, which is called GUT, which stands for Godot Unit Testing. It's made by Butch Wesley and other contributors. And it's a great way to do unit testing in Godot. So let's set it up. What we first have to do is we have to download it from the assetlib. So if we go to assetlib, search for GUT, we can download it. After it's downloaded, we can install it. Now we can install it. Now it says successfully installed. Now we have to activate it. Go to project settings. And then on the plugins, you can enable it. You can see the version. Close this. And what we can do now is we can create a GUT scene. This is the scene where we have an overview of all the tests that are being run. So we can create a new scene called GUT, or which extends from GUT. Maybe I should create in a new scene. So delete this. Scene, new scene, and the root node can be GUT. Here you have a screen that shows the information about the test you're running. Make it bigger, like this, and let's save it to GUT. Save, already had one. And here you also have, in the inspector, you have some properties to set up your tests. So what we want to do is we want to do run and load. So when we start the scene, it will automatically run all the tests that it can find. And now we're gonna set up which test to run. And we do that here. You can see the test prefix and the file prefix. So it's gonna look for files that have the test underscore prefix and the extension GD. And now we have to tell it in which directory it has to look. So if we create a directory for this, right click it in the file system and then new folder test. Now we can create another folder called unit. And now on the right in the directory structure, we can say test unit, select this folder. Now when we run this, it will look into this directory and search for files with the test underscore name and the GD file extension for tests to run. So for the example of testing something, I made a really small class with only two methods in it. This is a normal scene with a player in it and a player script, and the player can have HP added or removed, and the starting HP is 100. So let's write some tests for it to see if this actually works. So what we're going to do first is in the test unit folder, right click, create a new script. Let's call it test underscore player. Here we have it. And now what we have to do is we have to extend this script from the GUT testing script. And if we go to the quick start page, here it shows we have to extend from this. We can use this. And then we can create our test. So let's call it test. Test at HP. So we want to test our player, so let's create an instance of our player by using the normal way, preloading the script. and create a new instance of the player GD script. So now we have our player, and it will be initialized with HP 100 and these methods. So now what we can do is, let's say we want to create a test to add 50 HP. So in the end, it should have 150 HP. So we can do player add HP 50. And now this method doesn't return anything, but we can access this field. So what we can do then is we can assert the HP value of player to see if it actually is 150. So we do that by assert equals. And then if we look in the documentation, this method comes from the got library. Here it says got expected and a text. So what we got is the player HP. What we expect is 150, and we can here put clarifying text that will be shown. So what we got is player HP. We expect it to be 150. And here we can say when 50 HP is added, the player should have 150 HP. So now we can run it. We have to open the scene, and on the top right you can say play scene. And here you can see the screen we just made in the new scene. We get a summary. It says here scripts. One script was found. One test was run. And it succeeded. And here we can see that too. So let's try it. So let's try a failing script or a failing test. So let's say we make this 200. We expect then when we run the scene that it fails. So on the top right, let's rerun it. And here we can see one script found, one test was being done, and zero passing a search and one failing a search. So this is how you can create unit tests in Godot. Before we finish it up, I wanted to show something else. If we add another test for the removal of HP, so test remove HP, we have player and then remove HP. So we remove 50 HP. In a normal scenario, when a player has 100 HP and we remove 50, we expect it to have 50. If we do that, if we assert equal this and we say 50, it will fail because the player already has, we create one instance of the player. Then we do add HP, so it's 150, and then we remove some. So it will be 100. So let's see. To the scene. We can play the scene. And indeed, it here it shows us that we have a failing test. It runs the remove HP first. In any case, like one of them is wrong. So to counteract that, to start with a newly instantiated player every time we do test, we can use one of the precondition methods, which are described here, and we can say before each, which means before each method that is being run, it will run this code. So then we can say func before each. And what we can do is we can move the player instantiation to the before each. So we say player so every time we run a test now, it will first run this method and it will create a new player instance. So if we run it now, both tests are passing. And this is how you can test your code in Godot. I hope you liked it. Have a nice day.